guys, Kristen here. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to share with you some books from my TBR shelf that I plan to finally read this year. These are all books I was really, really excited to read, and just for some reason they sat on my shelf collecting dust, or I put them on my TBR list on Goodreads and thought I would read them really soon, and then it just never happened. These are just books that I really, really, really want to read, and so I want to commit myself to reading these books sometime soon in the next couple of months. Before I start, if you have not subscribed to the channel yet, go ahead and do that. I was trying to reach a goal of 500 subscribers, and you guys amazingly got me past 500 subscribers way faster than I thought was going to happen. So now I've set a new goal of 1,000 subscribers, and if you would like to help me reach that goal, or if you just enjoy my videos, hit that subscribe button, and at the end of the video, if you enjoy the video, hit the like button or leave me a comment in the comment section to let me know. Okay, so here we go. The first on this list is Truth Witch by Susan Denard, and I'm starting with this one because this is a little bit different than the other books. This has not been sitting on my shelf collecting dust for a long time. This book totally flew under my radar. I didn't know anything about it until people started making their best books of 2016 lists, and it started popping up all over the place. One of my co-bloggers absolutely loved it. A lot of booktubers have been talking about it, and for some reason, I just didn't know anything about it when it came out last year. So I purchased this with one of my Christmas gift cards, and I will hopefully be reading this sometime soon. The next book on this list is Of Fire and Stars by Audrey Colthurst. This was on my TBR shelf on Goodreads. I didn't have a physical copy, but I was interested in this book way before it even got released, and for some reason I just never bought myself a copy. I just purchased other books instead and just didn't get around to this one. And then the fates aligned, and this was the book in the December outgrade box, so it is definitely a sign that I am supposed to read this book. This one is bumped up on my TBR shelf because Diversathon is taking place at the end of January, and this is one of the books I plan to read for that, so hopefully that will happen and this one can move from my TBR shelf to my red shelf. Next on the list is Mistborn by Brandon Sanderson. This book has been on my TBR for a very long time, and I did not own a physical copy of it until recently. I just really was intrigued by how much everybody seems to love this series. However, it is definitely intimidating. They are very, very long books, and it's adult epic fantasy, and I haven't read a lot of epic fantasy, and I've been reading a lot of YA lately. There's really no excuse. I just need to set aside some time and let myself get lost in the world of Mistborn. Next is The Winter's Curse by Marie Rutkowski. Rutkowski? Hope I said that right. I really actually don't know a lot about this book. I know that the books in the series have like gorgeous covers, and I know that the writing is sideways, which for some reason I find really intriguing, and I know basically what it says on the back of the book, and that's it. But I don't really know anybody who's read this trilogy. I don't know, maybe it's the cover. Bumping this one up on my TBR list, probably not this month. This will probably be a goal for me for February. Okay, the next book from my TBR shelf that I plan to read is The Rose and the Dagger by Renee Afdia. I read The Wrath and the Dawn over the summer, and I absolutely loved it, and I had this sitting on my shelf just collecting dust and doing nothing. For some reason, I just never read it. I have tried to read this book twice for two other readathons and just haven't gotten to it in my reading pile. I have no idea what's keeping me from reading this. I've heard it's great. I love the first book. I just keep grabbing other books instead of this, so I really, really want to commit to reading this because Renee Afdia has a new series starting, and the first book in that series comes out in May, and I want to be all wrapped up in The Wrath and the Dawn before I read The Flame and the Mist, so this needs to happen very, very soon. All right, next I actually have two books that are classics. One of them is really, really classic, and I cannot believe I haven't read it, and that is Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen. I have seen, like, every movie adaptation of Pride and Prejudice, but I've never gone back and read the book. I actually did a lot of searching to find the perfect copy of the book, which is silly because there are so many beautiful and unique copies, but I wanted something that had a really pretty cover, but I did not want a hardback. This is a small version of the book. This cover kind of looks like a hardback, and it keeps its shape like a hardback, but is actually a softback, and it's just really lovely. It's hot pink and turquoise, and all of these on the front are words or phrases that come right from the actual book, and it has this really soft, leathery feel to it. I just really enjoy holding it in my hands, so I'm really looking forward to reading this. I thought I might get to this last month in December, and it didn't happen, but I really want to read this soon. I know a lot of people absolutely love this book. I have actually always preferred Emma to Pride and Prejudice, but like I said, I've never read Pride and Prejudice, so I'm wondering if actually reading the book will change my mind. We will see. Okay, the next book isn't really a classic like Pride and Prejudice. It was not published 100 years ago. This book is a classic in the sense that it is definitely not new, and that is Stardust by Neil Gaiman. This movie is one of my all-time favorite movies. I must have seen this movie 100 times, but I have never gone back and read the book. So I just recently purchased this also with a gift card from Christmas, and I am really hoping to get to it soon because if I love the movie that much, I'm almost positive I'm just going to adore the book because that's usually the case. The book is usually better than the movie, and I am really, really looking forward to kind of reliving one of my favorite movies in its original format. I think that's gonna be really exciting. If you have not seen this movie, you have to go find this movie immediately. It is fabulous. It's one of my all-time favorite movies, and if you like fantasy and romance, it's just such a good fantasy movie. All right, the next book I'm about to hold up, you guys are all gonna go, what? And that is A Court of Thorns and Roses by Sarah J. Maas. No, I have not read these books yet. The reason that is probably surprising if you've been subscribed to my channel for a little while is that I marathon read the Throne of Glass books and I've reviewed all of them here on the channel. But when I finished reading those, I kind of just wanted to take a break. I didn't want to read both of her series back to back because then that would be it. They would be done. So I decided to put a couple of months between the two series, and we're coming to about time. This is a bit of a Beauty and the Beast retelling, and Beauty and the Beast is one of my all-time favorite movies from when I was a kid. Pretty sure I'm going to love this book. I didn't want to read it and then not have any more books of hers on my shelf to read because that would make me sad. This one is coming up very soon though. I know that the third book in this series is releasing, I believe, in May. So I'm going to read this book and the sequel before May for sure. Okay, the last book on this list is An Ember in the Ashes by Sabah Tahir. And I apologize if I totally just butchered that name. An Ember in the Ashes is a book that I've been wanting to read for a really long time. I picked this up on an impulse, I think going through like Target or something. And it's been sitting on my shelf for over a year now, and the sequel has already come out, and I just can't believe I haven't read it yet. I feel like I'm really gonna love it, but for some reason, I just don't grab it off my shelf, and I don't know why, but I'm gonna remedy that very soon because I'm making a commitment to read this book in the first part of 2017. Doesn't mean I don't have other books to read though. New releases coming out all the time, and I have ARCs on my shelf I need to get to, and there are series that I'm in the middle of that I need to finish. So many books, a little time. Let me know what books you guys have on your TBR shelf that you hope to get to in the first part of this year. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you soon with another video. Bye!